Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. Not so long time ago I got my hands on these two SMPS or switch mode power supply units. They are rated to have a voltage output of 24 volts and a current capability of 4 amperes. My plans are to use both of them on a simple symmetrical power supply later on for my lab. But because they are outputting just 24 volts, I will show you how can you modify them to get a higher or lower voltage, same as a buck boost converter does it. I need them to output at least 32 volts. Now from the number I guess it's a simple SMPS based on a flyback topology, due to the power output which is nearly 100 watts per unit, which is enough for most of my application. But before we start, shall I warn you all that this is a main operated SMPS, which is quite little if tampered with it if you don't know what you are doing. So it will be your responsibility for any damage and harm to yourself if you are planning to tamper pretty much with any SMPS. You have been warned. Let's start modifying one at a time. First part is to open it. From my experience, some of them are very hard to open and some like this one simply as a piece of cake. After the unit is opened, the PCB is extracted and inspected. What we are looking here is quite simple, let's go through all components and explain them. At the beginning we provide 110 or 220 volts. In my case 250 AC, this is an automatically universal power supply, that's why it has a wide range of voltage at the input. Some units have a switch which we have to switch manually to get it working. After we got a fuse, this is to protect the unit in the event of a particular failure. And then a NTC, a negative temperature coefficient. This component is for limiting the inrush, which is due to the big capacitor water at the input. The next component is a common choke. This in combination with the yellow cap, they form a simple filter for the SMPS unit by blocking the unwanted harmonics being dependent back in the power line. After that, a large cylindrical component called capacitor will smooth out the voltage from the main power line. They usually have as well a resistor in parallel to discharge them afterwards after being unplugged. Then a tiny bridge rectifier which is just rectifying the voltage from AC to DC for the unit to work properly. After we got a simple oscillator chip based on OB2269. Then a MOSFET along with a snubber network which will prevent it from getting burned. After that we come across a huge component called a transformer. This is where the magic happens. It consists, because of the topology of it, three windings. A primary winding, which is switched by the MOSFET, which is controlled by the OB2269 chip. After a feedback winding, usually identified by being the winding with the less turn, and also the thinnest wire ever possible on it. Then we got a secondary winding. From here, it goes straight to the half bridge rectifier diode, then it gets converted back to DC direct current, and after getting filtered and smoothed out by the little inductor and the two capacitor we got at the output, it will be fading this component, which is called a optocoupler. This is a component which consists of two internal components, an LED and a phototransistor. Its job is to provide a galvanized isolated signal from the secondary winding back to the OB2269 chip. And then the last tiny transistor, which is not a transistor but a voltage reference IC in a body of 2092 transistor. This is the component which stabilizes the output voltage of pretty much any SMPS out there. To this one we can tap in and change the resistor, which is usually between pin 1 called reference voltage and pin 2, which is usually the ground or the anode of the TL431 IC. To change the voltage of any particular SMPS, there are two ways of doing it. First one is to tap on the TL431 reference voltage, and the second one is a bit harder but still manageable. It is to add or remove some of the turn on the transformer. But because this is a flyback topology, theoretically we can get up to 150 watts. But that's a theory, we will get a bit less due to the losses in the power supply unit and also the transformer. I will go the simpler route of it, that will be to tap into the TL431 using a 10K linear potentiometer and solder it between the reference pin and the anode, right where the 2.7 resistor is located. After that was sorted, I will be powering the unit using a safety box, which is just a halogen bulb in series with the load. For more detail, check the video description or up here. After the first power up, the safety lamp flashed for a brief moment, and you can see that the voltage is jumping up and down. This is called hiccup mode. This is because the voltage feedback is skewed by the pot. That's why it's better if you remove the resistor and set the pot to exactly the same value, but I cheated a bit. After I start adjusting the pot, we can see that the voltage can be changed from a minimum of 19 volts up to 33, which is plenty. After we get the desired voltage, remove the pot without turning it, and with the help of a ohm function of a multimeter, probe for a resistance between the pins 2 and 3. Mine is around 2K, so I grab a 2K resistor from my resistor tray and replace the 2.7 with it, and the PUC is modified successfully. I got about 32.8 volts, which is enough for what I need. Let's give it a load to see how it will handle. For that I will be using some 35 watts halogen spotlights. I got 3 of them. After connecting them in series, I will power up the unit. It starts pulsating as it's trying to power up. This is not that it has been overloaded. It's just my safety box, which cannot sustain more than 70 watts going through it. After removing the safety box, I plug it normally, and it power up without much hassle. The voltage is quite stable and also the current is enough, with a load of about 88 watts. It's working as expected. The last modification I will do is to remove the output cable and also the C13 connector. After that I start doing the second one. And like so I got my two SMPS ready for the power supply. Till then I hope you have learned something interesting today and I shall see you all the next one. Till then have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!